What's up guys, in this tutorial I will show you how to invite a user in Xbox Social on your Windows PC. This should be quite an easy tutorial. For more information, click on the first link in the description below. While playing a game on your Windows PC, use the shortcut Windows key and G. This will toggle your Xbox game bar overlay. In case nothing is opening up, then open up your Windows settings. Under Gaming, click on Game Mode. Make sure to enable Game Mode. This will not only allow you to access the Xbox Game Bar overlay, but it will in addition improve your overall performance when playing a game on your PC. When using the Windows key and G shortcut, you can preview all of the widgets in the top navigation. Click on the Xbox Social icon to toggle your Xbox Social widget. On this window, you can preview your username, online status, friends list, and chats if you're logged in with your Microsoft account. When right-clicking one of your friends, navigate to Party and then Invite to Party. This will send an invite to the user, and when accepted, they will show up in this widget as a new friend in your party. You can also navigate to Game and invite the user to a game which supports multiplayer. In case the user is not yet in this list, but they are connected via Steam or Facebook, then click on the Find Friends icon, which will allow you to link your Steam and Facebook account to make it easier to invite friends to your game party in future using Xbox Social. Next, navigate to your Xbox Game Bar settings. In your Notifications section, take a look at some Xbox Social options, which you can change from here. I prefer to disable most of these notifications, but this will come down to personal preference. In case you experience issues with Xbox Game Bar, then search for Xbox Game Bar in your Start menu search and click on App Settings. Here, allow the app to access your camera and microphone. These will only be utilized when using the in-app chat or when recording your gameplay. Set the Let this app run in the background option to power optimized. Lastly, scroll down and select Repair. This will take a second to make sure that the application is complete and up to date. You might need to look back into your Microsoft account after repairing the Xbox Game Bar application. In case you have any further issues or problems following this tutorial, then I suggest following my extensive guide linked in the description below. I hope this helps you out. Leave a comment if you have any questions, and see you in the next one.